TLIF stands for Transforaminal Lumbar Interbody Fusion. The procedure aims to reduce any leg pain that you may have by removing nerve pressure due to bone spurs or disc material. At the same time, the TLIF also aims to ease back discomfort by removal of the damaged disc and insertion of implants to help your bones fuse together.
Hi, I'm Mike Krzyzewski, coach of Duke University men's basketball team. When you hear words like work or hard, don't shy away from them. My players learn to love work when they see results. What's really hard is living in pain, but you don't have to. Consider what your level of play is right now. Now think about how long you can afford to stay that way and still get the job done.
As you prepare for a fusion, your surgeon will want to know your medical history in order to identify anything that could affect safe conditions for anesthesia and bone healing. It's important to pay attention to your nutrition in those weeks leading up to surgery. Diets high in protein, calcium, and vitamin D help in the bone healing process. In addition, patients should stop smoking or chewing tobacco 4 weeks before the surgery and several months after because nicotine impairs bone healing. Alcohol, caffeine, and herbals can cause bleeding problems and should not be taken 1 week before or 2 weeks after surgery. Also, some medications should not be taken prior to or after the procedure, such as anti-inflammatory medicines like aspirin and ibuprofen. Check with your surgeon for recommendations about these. Your physician will also discuss the possible risks associated with back surgery. The main concerns include infection, inadequate bone healing, loosening of the screws or cage implant, or persisting pain after surgery from scar tissue. While all of these risks are rare, any one of them could create a need for future surgery. Be sure to discuss these risks and any additional concerns you may have with your surgeon. During the TLIF procedure, the patient lies face down on a bed designed especially for the procedure. Through an incision on your back, the surgeon begins by accessing the section of the spine that needs to be fused. First, any bone spurs and disc material pressing on the nerve is removed and the opening around the nerve enlarged. Then the surgeon will remove almost the entire disc between the vertebrae to create a clean space for fusion between the bones. If the disc has collapsed from disease, the vertebrae are moved back into a normal position. The surgeon then prepares the area where the disc was removed so that the spinal implant can be placed for support. After measuring the size of the space, the surgeon inserts an implant made of bone or a synthetic material into the disc space. This implant gives critical support to the spine and aids bone fusion. The surgeon then places bone graft or other special material into the space around the implant to stimulate bone growth, which will take several months. Then, on the back part of the vertebrae, small screws called pedicle screws are inserted into the bone, and connecting rods are inserted into the screws to give the spine extra stability. This holds everything in place as it heals and allows for more activities after surgery. Over time, the vertebrae will grow together or fuse. After surgery, patients typically stay in the hospital 3 to 5 days. While pain varies a few weeks after surgery, you should expect major soreness in your back for the first several days. If the doctor uses bone from the pelvis for the bone graft, you'll also feel soreness in your hip area. Pain is managed with medication for 2 to 4 weeks, and rehabilitation begins in the hospital. A physical therapist will help you get out of bed and walk safely around the hospital. The first couple of days after surgery, patients usually need a walker, and a back brace may also be used when moving. It's important to keep an eye on that incision. If it becomes red, tender, or if there's drainage, alert your doctor. Some minor leg numbness or discomfort is common for a few days, but let your doctor know if it's severe or lasts more than 1 or 2 weeks. During recovery, you will need to limit your activities. Walking will help with healing, but you'll need to avoid heavy housework. You can use ice packs every 4 to 6 hours to help alleviate muscle soreness those first couple of weeks. You may resume driving and sexual activity 4 to 6 weeks after surgery, depending on your condition. Generally, around 6 weeks after your surgery, you can return to work, but your doctor will help you decide the best time to do that. It typically takes about 6 months or more for the bone fusion to completely heal. Your doctor will monitor progress of the fusion healing with x-rays or a scan. During that time, high-intensity activities like running and heavy lifting will need to be avoided to make recovery as smooth as possible.
My surgery has not only helped me as a coach, but it has also allowed me to become a more active husband, father, and grandfather. I was pretty nervous about the surgery at first, but I'm so happy I went through with it. When I returned to physical activity, I was really amazed at the things I could do. How many times do you say, "I don't know if I have the time to do it"? You can make the time to do it. Why would you want to live with back problems? Positive attitude matters. You must tell yourself, "I'm not going to let pain win." But listen, I'm Coach K, not Dr. K. Make sure you ask your doctor if a spine procedure is right for you.